Everybody, welcome to my makeup haul video. I'm going to be showing you some of the makeup that I've purchased in the past few months, and I'm going to do a little bit of review as well. So I bought a whole bunch of makeup from different websites and different stores. It wasn't all like one big purchase, but it was like little bits of pieces here and there. The first one that I'm going to show you is my ColourPop orders. I got the ColourPop lippy pencil. This is just like a standard lip pencil. I got mine in the shade Drop Top, and it's a peachy color, and as you can see, I've kind of like made it into a stump, and apparently you can sharpen it, even though this is like plastic. It's a bit too light for me, so it's actually lighter than my actual lip color. I want it to be more of a, like a darker nude. ColourPop has come out with new products since my last purchase, and one of them is the Blotted Lip. It's supposed to make your lips look like you've just applied a light layer of lipstick. It's not supposed to be like a tinted lip balm, but it's not supposed to be like a lipstick. It's supposed to be in between. So I got the Blotted Lip in the shade Candy Floss, which I am a huge fan of this color. It's like an orangey brown terracotta brick color. It's still quite pigmented and it looks really flattering on my skin tone as well. They also have the Ultra Blotted Lip, which I think are more pigmented, but it comes in like a, it looks like a lip gloss. But this is the only one I got, and I'm really, really happy with this color. And the other thing that I got from ColourPop is this face palette. So this is the palette. There is a peachy blush here, which I am wearing on my cheeks, and the highlighter that I'm also wearing on my cheeks. When mine arrived, I opened it and the highlighter was shattered. It had broken and crumbled into pieces and it fell all over my lap. So I emailed them saying, it arrived broken, the blush is fine, but the highlighter is broken. Can I get like a refund? And they sent me a code worth the price of the palette, which was $16. So if I use the code to get a new palette, I still have to pay for shipping, which isn't really ideal. And then my friend sent me a link on how to fix pressed powder makeup. So what I did was I got a bottle of isopropyl alcohol. This is rubbing alcohol. I got this from the pharmacy for about $7. For cleaning and sterilizing electronic items, grooming tools, earrings, and newly pierced ears. So what I did, and I posted this on my Instagram story as well, I put all the broken crumbs of the pressed powder into a bowl. Put about 1 teaspoon of this rubbing alcohol roundabout. I wasn't really sure. I put a few drops in at a time and then mixed it until it was sort of like a paste consistency, I would say, but just enough to spoon it back into the pan and smooth it out. I left it to dry with the lid closed, and in the morning when I opened it, it was dry. It looked fine like this, but when I smelt it, it smelled like alcohol. So what I did was I left it open, and then the next day the alcohol smell was gone. Now I have pretty much the powder back in its normal form, and I'm really, really happy that I was able to fix this. So I still have a $16 voucher for ColourPop. Let me know if you've tried anything from their website that you really, really like that I think I should try. The other things I got from ColourPop is their pressed eyeshadows. I got Dreamboat, which is like a dusty rose pink, and I got Note to Self, which is a medium sort of caramel brown color, and this is the color that I'm wearing all over my crease at the moment. The other pressed eyeshadow that I got is by Makeup Geek, which is my favorite eyeshadow brand. This is in the shade Desert Sand. So I use ColourPop Note to Self all over my crease as a transition shade, and I use this as like a build-up color. I bought a face palette. This is by the brand Natio. It comes with 2 blushes, a highlighter in the middle, and 6 eyeshadows. There's one matte, which is like a peachy pinky one, and there's a shimmery pink one, and the highlighter is like a golden champagne color. It's beautiful. And then the eyeshadows are all mauve kind of shade range. Quality is good for the price point, which is about, I think it was $23, and you get all of this. I made an online purchase on Nude by Nature. They had like a 30% off everything, and that brand is actually quite affordable. So I got a lipstick in the shade Sassy, and it's like a dark brick brown color. And then the other lipstick I got is one by Crop, and I got this in Australia. I got a lipstick in the shade Spice. Everything was all packaged, like there were no testers, because it was sold in like a grocery store, but I really love this color. It's like a pinky nude, and it's probably like my 19th pink nude. So here in New Zealand, we don't have the cosmetic items, we only have their facial skincare. So there's like oils and makeup removers and lotions. But I hope they bring the rest of the cosmetic line into New Zealand because I really like this lipstick. It's really comfortable to wear. That's not all the lip products I purchased though. I purchased two more. So when I was in Sydney, I saw Sephora. I thought that's a really bad idea to walk in there. So what did I do? I walked in there just to have a look around, right? The most dangerous aisle in Sephora is just before you get to the counter where everything is in like mini form and everything is like a lot more affordable than the full size items. So I was like, oh, kind of like this, kind of like this, kind of like this. And I was like holding it in my hands and I was like, I kind of need a basket. So I got a basket, put all the stuff in there. And then I saw a promotion that they had in Sephora and it was like buy a number of travel size items and get a free travel bag. And I was like, oh, that's really cool. I'm traveling and I need a travel bag because I don't like my Gladwear Ziploc bag that I put all my liquids in. So I started buying the travel size items to get the free bag, which now thinking about it doesn't make sense because it's just like a standard bag. Like there's nothing really special about it, but... So I got the mini size Sephora brand eye makeup remover. This removes waterproof makeup as well. This bottle is really great if I'm only taking carry-on items. It can go right in this bag and it would just pass right through security. The other thing that I got from Sephora are these two Tarte lip paint. This came in a set. This one is the quick dry lip paint in the shade Rosé. And this one is the creamy matte lip paint in the shade FOMO. This is the one I'm wearing on my lips right now. I love this color. It's like a berry purpley pink. And when you apply it, it's really, really smooth, really creamy. A little bit patchy at times, so you need to apply a couple of coats of it. It comes in a dose applicator like this. This is going to be like my go-to bold lip color, while the other one is like the perfect nude. This is the quick dry. The quick dry one applies with a little bit of sheen to it, then it dries into a matte finish after a few seconds. It's really beautiful. Both of them are really comfortable to wear. Like, your lips feel like they are plush and really smooth and just really comfortable. That's what I really like about them. I love that they are small as well, so I can just throw one of these in my purse and just do touch-ups during the day. I'm really, really happy with this purchase. I got an LA Girl primer. This is the Pro Prep High Definition Smoothing Face Primer, and it's supposed to smooth and fill in fine lines and pores, which is exactly what I need. I just need it to kind of cover up my pores so it doesn't peek through my foundation. And this is usually about $13, but I picked it up in a makeup clearance store on Broadway for about $9, so that's really good. So that's the makeup I've purchased. I also have a few like tester samples of foundation, like high-end foundation. So what I do is I go into like Smith & Coe's or something, or while I was waiting at the airport, I go to the makeup counters and I ask for foundation samples. I have MAC, YSL, Dior, and Giorgio Armani. The MAC one is a foundation called Next to Nothing. It's a really, really sheer coverage foundation. It's really lightweight. You can see your skin showing through it. So it's really natural, but it's not the coverage that I'm after. I'm after like a more like medium coverage, whereas this is really, really light. Hence the name Next to Nothing. I got the YSL one. I don't remember what it was. I got it just because I wanted to try out an expensive foundation. I follow Jaclyn Hill and she raves on and on about the Giorgio Armani Luminous Silk Foundation. I got a sample. I love it. Absolutely love it. I think the full size is like $90, so I'm not going to be purchasing it, but it was so beautiful. Because it is a luminous foundation, it really does make your skin look dewy and luminous. If I were to save up for a makeup item, it would be that one. And then the Dior Forever Foundation, which Jaclyn Hill also loves. She says this one is better than the Luminous Silk, or at least on par with it. It is beautiful, but I love the Giorgio Armani one more. This one also makes your skin look natural. It has great coverage, but I like the finish of the Giorgio Armani one. Like at the end of the day, when I was looking into the mirror, my foundation was still there and my skin looked amazing. So yeah, that's a life hack. If you want to try high-end foundation but you don't want to purchase it, just go into the store, try a few on the back of your hand, ask for a free sample, and they put it in their little tube like this, it lasts a couple of weeks, at least a couple of applications depending on the coverage of the foundation. You can use it to see how it looks in natural light and see how long it lasts and see if the color actually matches your skin tone. So that's all the makeup that I've bought. I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know what makeup you've purchased recently and if you like it, or let me know if there are any makeup that I should try. Thank you for watching. I'm filming Isaac.